Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Chest. It is an entertaining movie, but I wouldn't put this over the original film. But in a lot of ways, this is still a fun adventure that the whole family can enjoy. In a lot of ways, this is a decent sequel even all these years later. So the story of this movie is that Will Turner and Elizabeth Swann, they are getting married, but their wedding is interrupted by Cutler Beckett, who charges them for helping Jack Sparrow escape in the first film. And so Will has to go on this adventure to find Jack Sparrow in order to help his fiance. And from there, you got one entertaining adventure, new characters, new settings, and the story is very enjoyable. You know, in a lot of ways over the years, I've only seen this film probably like a few times. And so when I had watched the movie for the first time in so many years, I was like, you know, this is doing real well. Especially the performances from the actors, the humor, the musical score that was done by Hans Zimmer, the action sequences, as well as the special effects and direction. Like, it comes together to make a decent movie, in my opinion. Now, I don't believe this is a bad movie. But I felt like, as a story perspective, it takes a step back compared to the first film. Even the characterization of Jack Sparrow is not as great as in the first movie. Not that it's bad, but I will say Jack Sparrow, he had more moments to shine in the first installment than he did in this one. Nonetheless, though, this is a high-quality movie. And while it's not perfect, it's still very entertaining for what it is. As cool as this movie is, I really felt like if they were taking out some things out of this film, then it would work better. Like, for example, when they go to the island and come across those islanders, I really felt like it was a waste of time because they could have cut that section out and the movie wouldn't have suffered for it. And another issue I had with this film was it's over 2 hours. It's a little bit longer than the first movie. And I was saying this film probably could have been 1 hour and 40 minutes and they still would have gotten the point across. Still though, there are things I enjoy about this film, despite the negatives there. Rigetti and Pintel, they're just great, you know, with their friendship, especially since the first movie. These guys, they've been through a lot. And you know, that's one of the comedic duos that makes this movie entertaining for what it is. And the new character, Davy Jones, Bill Nye did an amazing job. Seriously, he's an interesting villain. You know, he used to be human, but then he became this part man, part crab, part octopus. And I have to say that I'm glad they didn't use makeup. The CGI looks amazing. This movie won an Academy Award for Best Visual Effects. And I will say that his crew, which one of them consists of a hammerhead, it looks beautiful. What can I say? The CGI is just great. And another thing I want to point out, the new character of Cutler Beckett, you know, he wants to redeem himself, especially since, you know, he's entrusted with Jack Sparrow and, you know, he wants to help him, you know, for honor. Even Will's father, Bill Turner, shows up in this movie serving on the crew of the Flying Dutchman. And I will say, while we don't get much interaction between those two characters, seeing them at least on the boat interacting is cool to see. I wish they would have done more with it, but I will say that we finally have learned about his father. And what I will say is that I wish we got more backstory on the whole lack of relationship between the two. And while I wouldn't rank this above the first film, this is still a film I would highly recommend you check out if you've never seen this one. I'm giving this film a 7 out of 10. Some story issues, it's long length. That's really what is the things that kept me from rating this even higher. This is an entertaining movie for a Friday night or a weekend. Certainly before the assertiveness of the fourth and fifth movies. This movie here is still rewatchable even today. Plus the action scenes, especially the ones that had the Kraken in it, are a joy to look at. And that's my review of Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Chest. Okay, leave your comments down below in the section and let me know what you think about this film. Stay tuned, my review of Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End is coming up pretty soon. Alright, this is Slim Guy 172 saying, peace out.